Have you ever wondered what pro DJs are doing behind the decks, or how they get some of those really cool, unique sounds, mixes, and blends? Well, in this video, I'm going to break down what all the pro DJs are doing. What's up everyone, Jamie Hartley here from Crossfader. In today's video, I'm going to be breaking down some of the techniques used by pro DJs, things that you may have heard them apply to their mixes and sets before, but I'm going to show you how they sound on controllers and various pieces of equipment, software, and hardware. This video is perfect for any beginner DJs who have seen some of their favorite DJs do some really crazy stuff on their equipment and have always wondered what's going on behind the decks. It's also great for any DJs out there struggling for inspiration or what to learn next. I'm going to explain some of these techniques as we go along so you can see what's happening on the equipment and you can get some ideas to maybe apply to your next DJ set. As always, remember to hit that like button, drop a comment at the end of the video which one of these techniques was your favorite and which one you're going to apply in your next DJ set. Make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon. Let's get stuck into it. First technique used by pro DJs is layering. Layering is important because this allows you ultimately to blend two or more tracks together. But there are some rules that can be applied around layering. There are some things to think about when it comes to layering tracks together. Now, I have three examples here to show you different ways that layering is applied by pro DJs with various pieces of equipment and genres. In the first example, we're looking at how pro DJs can use more than two channels or more than two decks to layer up two, three, or even four pieces of audio. Now you've got to think about what pieces of audio you're layering together. So in this example, what I'm doing is layering two build-ups together and then have a vocal that can come in over the drop on the third channel while performing some cutting in and out with the faders. All I wanna do is follow you, just say the word. Please remember this video is just to explain what the techniques are. If you really want some in-depth tutorials on any of these techniques, then make sure you check out our online DJ courses at wearecrossfader.co.uk, where we break a lot of this stuff down in a lot more detail. Our next example is a really easy one to master, but you might need to sign up to a DJ Ready record pool such as BPM Supreme, which we have an affiliate code with, or places like DJ City. These record pools provide a cappella intros and it's a really good way to create seamless transitions in your set, layering the a cappella intro over the instrumental outro of another track. It's a really simple layering technique, but it works really effectively. Let's take a listen. This technique is used by a lot of drum and bass DJs. It's the double drop technique. Again, it's another example of how layering can really add energy and something really professional to your DJ sets. What the DJs do here is they line up the drops of two tracks so they're going to land together. Now, for this to happen, you need to understand phrasing in music, something that's taught in our beginner courses, and you can basically line up the drops of two tracks. You've got to also make sure that when you're applying this technique that you're mixing tracks that work well in key together and you're using your EQs effectively to balance the two audio sources when they drop in. Later on in the example, we use the hot cues to jump to another part of the drop and continue the layering.
I'll give you realness till the fade is full again. Me and my brothers keep the dancing motion till the end. If you want test the set, you best respect the blank around. Here we don't play, don't pretend, no. Yeah, I'll give you realness till the fade is full again. Me and my brothers keep the dancing motion till the end. If you want test the set, you best respect the blank around. Here we don't play, don't pretend, no. Yeah.
A lot of pro DJs use patterns to their advantage. Now, if you think about it, all music is made up of patterns. Whether it's the melody in a song that goes up and down and then repeats itself, it's a pattern. Whether it's the drums in a song, the repetition of the drums creates a pattern. Now, pro DJs could enhance that experience. When they're mixing between tracks, they could use the faders to cut patterns in and out. A popular trick that's used is DJs will take a loop, tighten it right down, and then create a pattern by cutting that loop in and out during a build-up or in certain sections of a song. And this works really well to create energy and atmosphere and really obviously stand out from the crowd when it comes to making DJ videos and promotional videos online as well. Let's take a look at this example.
My soul is under pressure. You are my sweet surrender. Let me, I will break. Won't you let me, I will break. When you breathe, I'll be your oxygen. Keep you deep in my adrenaline. I could
This technique is used by a lot of competition DJs and performance DJs. You might see this technique used in things like the Red Bull 3-Style competition. You can create patterns with hot cues, and this comes down to finger drumming. Now, like I said before, drums are patterns in music, and you can use certain elements of a song. In this example, we're using some vocal sounds, and we can play those vocal sounds with the hot cues like a drum, and basically finger drum a new pattern with the sounds. This is a really cool way to switch between genres. As you can see, I'm going from something up at 128 BPM or around there down to around 100 BPM. And you can switch that genre really easily by just practicing playing along to the drums of some music with your hot cues. Obviously, this takes time to get the muscle memory right, but keep practicing and you can start finger drumming with your music too. The final technique used by pro DJs is creating energy, and that can be done in different ways. But one of the main ways that this is done is by utilizing the effects that are available to us on DJ hardware and software. All hardware and software now has some form of effects unit or effects that can be applied to the music. Now, learning how to use these effects to your advantage is the trick. It's something we cover a lot in our online courses. But you can see in these examples that the first example, we're using effects to enhance the build-up. So it's taking the current build-up of a song, and by applying effects over it, in this example, we're using the spiral and some pad effects and record box, we can really enhance the build-up. And if you're playing to a large audience on a large sound system, it can really create some energy and atmosphere during that build-up before killing the effects and it drops in. Oh, Another way to use the effects to create energy or atmosphere is to apply effects over a big breakdown and to really enhance and bring out some of the key elements of that breakdown, whether it's a big vocal that's just by itself or whether it's some big synth or lead sounds. You can use the effects, things like reverbs and delays, to bring out those sounds and to make them sound really big, especially when playing to a large audience and a large crowd where you want to make use of the effects and enhance their listening experience. So in this example, we're using a huge breakdown, applying some reverb and some delay and some other effects in Traktor, combining them together to enhance the breakdown in this song. If you're intrigued to learn more about techniques like these, then make sure you click the link where you can have a look inside some of our courses. Ultimately, what I do in the courses is I break down techniques like this into much more detail so you can master them. We've got to think about using our hands in multiple ways, so we've got to think about the structure and the process of going through applying these techniques. If these are the kind of things that you want to learn, make sure to click that link. You can sign up and get access to some free tutorials from inside our courses so you can get an idea of what they're about. I hope anyone that's watched this might go away with some new ideas that they can just apply straight away to their DJ sets. And any beginner DJs out there, hopefully this has opened your eyes to what the possibilities are with your DJ equipment and where you may be going for your end goal. I'd love to know which one of these techniques is your favorite. So please comment below right now, which one was your favorite? Remember to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, hit the bell icon, do all that good stuff to help us keep making more videos like this. And hopefully I'll see you inside one of our courses very soon.